Hello, what is going on YouTube? Back again with another video on my channel, boys. And today I'm gonna be making a video on Hypersign, which is pretty interesting in my opinion. And that's why I decided to make a video on them. They obviously have their own, as you can see, token on ERC called HID or Hypersign Identity. And we are going to be talking about the token itself because in my opinion, it has a lot of potential. So that's why I decided to give it a try and to give it a review. So before we jump into it, I need to let you know that I'm not a financial advisor. You should always do your own research and you should always do your own due diligence because I don't take any responsibility for your action. And with that being said, we can jump into the video. So Hypersign, ensuring your users are who they say they are. No more passwords, privacy first, one-click login and registration and data monetization via DeFi. So it's combining some cool things here and definitely sounds exciting. So let's jump through the website as we always go and do. And then we are going to get into the, you know, chart action. They also have this, which is pretty much a document page kind of, you know, and it has all the informations here. So it's kind of cool actually. And we'll go over that later on as well. So stay tuned. So first of all, what is their mission? They want to eliminate data breaches, which, you know, this is kind of a thing that is not the best when it happens, to say the least, and we kind of know that because of the last situation that occurred with the social medias. You probably know what I'm talking about. Don't want to throw the names, but yeah, there was a big data breach lately. Empower humans to regain control of their personal data and democratize security for enterprises at an affordable price point. So what problems do they solve? So let's see what issues are faced by the consumers. First of all, the OTP, which is one-time password logins. OTP kind of like 2FA. So the OTP is based on SMS channels, which cannot be considered secure. Moreover, end users do not feel comfortable sharing phone numbers since phone numbers have become critical pieces of personal information. Insecure channel, wireless interception. Now this basically kind of points you out the risks. And then we have the social login as well. There are many problems we analyzed with social logins, tracking and tracing, data misuse, legacy authentication using passwords that require too much trust, and then again some problems with that. And then they are coming up with the solutions, which is pretty cool. Current solutions require much trust. In current identity systems, the IDP sits in the center of the ecosystem, making it a critical and trusted entity. Putting too much trust in one system is a problem. And then you have IDP here, which is identity provider, and it shows you kind of how it works. So Hypersign distributes the trust among stakeholders. So we replace trust with decentralized identifiers, which is DID. Users give personal data to issuers, which verify and issue cryptographically signed documents. The end user can store the verifiable credential in any user agent, such as mobile device or cloud agent, which only they have access to. The user can now present this credential to the service provider in a peer-to-peer fashion without notifying the identity provider or the issuer. The verifier need to not to rely on the issuer or the IDP to be available online for verification or credentials given by the user. And then you have an explanation of how it works, Hypersign Identity Network blockchain. Again, it shows you how everything goes through, all right, with all the steps. So it's pretty cool. They have those infographics here that are kind of showing you all the things. And they are also, you know, used by tens of clients such as InstaRace, TotemFi. So those guys are also quite known in the space and it's pretty cool. They also have their own token, as I said, which has a lot of potential, but we will get into the token. So unique features, two-way authentication. Hypersign not only enables websites to authenticate users, it also enables users to ensure that the website is safe before sharing any critical information, which builds trust and end phishing attacks. Independent verification. Hypersign enables websites to verify credentials on their own without the need to connect with any of the identity providers or their infrastructures. Lower operation cost and optimized workflow. So as you can see, those guys are basically working on improving the safety of the internet, kind of, we could say. into our data, which is pretty cool. And then we have an explanation of how it works. First of all, you have onboarding actors, credential issuance, registration and login. Again, some cool infographics that are showing you how everything works. And then we have tools and software. So that is HyperSign Identity Wallet for end user, which is a mobile app or a browser extension. You can store your private keys here, and if you want, you can go ahead and use it. Then they also have HyperSign Studio, which is for identity provider. It's a web application, and its usage is to manage connections and credentials. Then there is HyperSign SDK, also for service providers, to show QR code, connect with HyperSign blockchain network to verify credential, and HyperSign adapters. And I know that there is actually a lot of developers watching my channel. This could also be potentially cool thing to look out for you, right? Then we have some use cases, one of them being ID and access management, then verified data markets, ID whitelisting, which is pretty cool. Hyperfire gamified whitelisting solution will ban HID while using it as a payment method, which is another cool thing that I wanted to talk about. But maybe first of all, let's actually go through the use cases. So there is ID whitelisting and KYC infrastructure as well, which eliminates the risk and cost of storing user data and ensure compliance with local data privacy laws. And then we have the HID token itself, which I want to talk about. The HyperSign network comes with a basic payment infrastructure for any party to set up a payment layer. They have their own HID coin, HyperSign's network native currency, payment channel, which helps to set up the paper usage configuration and dashboard to manage the transaction. And then we have the utilities, one of them being paying for credentials and incentivizing identity and service providers and staking. So you are also able to stake and get more of the tokens to basically multiply your portfolio, which is pretty cool and can kind of, you know, gives you some additional values here. So it's nice the token has utility, and it kind of, I mean, it's quite important. It's nice to see that they have those utilities, because there is a lot of projects in the space that don't have the utilities, that are lacking the utilities, and those guys, I mean, they have the utility, which is pretty nice. And it's also a good utility, right? So paying for credentials, staking, incentivizing the identity and service providers, definitely great utilities. All right, there is also a liquidity pool, as you can see. And then we have the team. They have their LinkedIn's also shown here. So in case you want to check them out, you can go to their LinkedIn pages, as you can see. And they also have biographies. Those guys really have experience, and they definitely know how to lead this to a success, so it's pretty cool. Then we have the advisory team. They also have won a bunch of awards, as you can see. Best Decentralized Identity 2020, Best Decentralized Payment Security 2020, and some other ones, which is pretty nice. And then we have some of their investors, and I mean, look at this. There is quite a lot of them, actually. It's not some, it's a lot of investors and partners, very valuable partners. That's what I wanted to say. So it's really, really nice to see that in the implementations. Then we have the roadmap, as you can see, which is also looking pretty ambitious, in my opinion, and it's pretty cool. And also there is this Hyperfire. So Hyperfire is gamified whitelisting solution, which will ban HID while using it as a payment method, which is pretty cool, because it will decrease the supply of HID. Hyperfire is also already used by tens of clients like InstaRace, Option Room, and TotemFi. And Hyperfire is made upon HyperSign. So it's futuristic, as more people are going to talk about privacy and data ownership soon. So it's pretty cool to see those implementations, and it's really, really nice to see that they are actually occurring here. All right, I absolutely invite you to their social medias, guys. Join the Telegram, join the Twitter as well. 8,000 members here, 12,000 followers here. Definitely worth to check them out on both of those. And then we have the Hyperfire, which I just talked about. This is basically their marketing tool, and as I said, it's pretty, pretty cool. It's implemented, and it could get a lot of popularity, especially because people will talk about this privacy. And it's really, really nice. Again, it also burns the HID, decreasing the supply, increasing the demand, and increasing the price alongside the value. So it's pretty nice. They are also hosting some AMAs, as you can see, Hyperfire launch. Definitely look out for this one, guys, because this could be a major, major thing here. And I'm very excited about that. some listing announcements and other cool stuff. In case you want to get more information, I would recommend you to go ahead and check out their document page, okay? docs.hypersign.id, and that's where you can find some cool informations in their Gitbook. Pretty cool. You have introduction, you have explanations, right, for employees, features VIP protocol, and also you have informations for developers. Again, I know that a lot of you guys are watching my channel, and it's really, really cool to see that there are investors and developers as well that are integrating with each other. This channel is place for you, so yeah. And this project also might be place for you if you are a developer. So there is whole section for developers too, dashboard, all that kind of explanations, pretty cool. Now, talking about the token itself, I would say that it has a lot of potential because of the market cap, okay? Because of the market cap, because of the utilities about Hyperfire that is being launched, some other products on the way, and exciting stuff. This is still pretty new, if you think about it, and it has a lot of room to grow. It has a lot of potential, as you can see. So yeah, you can all obviously give them a good voting here, if you want to get them trending. Only on free exchanges yet, from which two are decentralized. As you can see, they are also on Quickswap, I believe, but it's not tracked here on CoinMarketCap. They are on Gate as well. Small volume, but it all has the room to grow, and that's what is most important, okay? This room for growth. So 25 cents, guys, 457,000 market cap. This is easily 100x potential here, okay? Could be definitely worth $25 per token, especially with the burns that are going to occur with Hyperfire. In my opinion, definitely could be a gem to look out for. Let me know in the comment section what do you think about Hypersign about Hyperfire. And if you are interested in checking them out, you can find the links down below in the description. Thank you so much for watching this video, and see you in the next ones coming out soon.